Hello everyone, I'm Nate Asher, and welcome back to Let's Play The Legend of Zelda The Wind Waker HD. In the last episode, we finished taking on the Tower of the Gods, went below Tower of the Gods under the sea, and got the Master Sword from the Temple of Time that was frozen in the past. And now, we are supposed to be making our way to the Forsaken Fortress. Something I wanted to get out of the way though that was going to make that a lot easier, if I can find it, is the brother of the wind god that taught us the Ballad of Gales or whatever. His brother, Cyclos, is flying around here, the one he talked about that was upset about his altar being destroyed. So if we see like a big menacing cyclone, we need to like get near it, because now that we have the bow, we can actually damage him. So far, all we've been able to find is this shark, who's very persistent, but still not. I mean, I guess I could practice my bow with it. Here's the cyclone we're looking for, though. The only one that's got, like, the funnel on the top of it. Let's just get a little bit closer here. And there he is. So, something I always forget to do, I don't know if you are playing to get all the photographs, but you don't ever see this guy again, so you may as well get a photograph of him. Okay, now. We took too long. See, where was that? That was... Yeah, we just have to go back this way. Okay. Wish it was daytime, we get at least meat. The heck of an arm you got there. What an eye, no one's ever been able to spot me in there before now. You obviously have mastery of the air, and now that we've established that you're quite the Wind Waker, let's see if you can handle this. Down, right, left, up. There we go. You learned the Ballad of Gales, okay? Wahoo, in the hands of the Wind Waker like you, my adorable little cyclones will be as happy as can be. If you need to move like the wind over the ocean deeps, just call on my cyclones. Well, I guess I'll head for home now. See you on down the road. So now we can just use the Ballad of Gales to fast travel wherever we want. So, go ahead and continue on to the Forsaken Fortress. This time it's going to kind of let us get near it because we have bombs, so it expects us to. And with the door out of the way, travel in here, but it's going to be a little bit different of a trip. Ganon has likely been made aware of our little incursion already. But you have the Master Sword. The sword shall shine in the darkness, casting back evil. With it in your hands, none can keep you from rescuing your sister. Do not be afraid. Alright, so, we'll see when we get up here that it's not exactly going to be that simple, because our path is blocked off.
Ha ha ha!
here we have Phantom Ganon. So just like in Ocarina of Time, there is a Phantom version of Ganon that we have to face just the same way that we face him in the Forest Temple in Ocarina of Time. So he's gonna fire that beam back at us, and we're gonna play Energy Ball Tennis. And then whenever we hit him with his own energy ball, we're just gonna rush up on him and attack him. He's gonna try and trick you by like disappearing and reappearing right behind you. So just always keep moving. Especially like right after you attack him, he's gonna try and get you with those tricks. So just keep running around and moving the camera around until he gets back in the air. Alright, so that was 3 rounds of that. As long as you get like a full combo in with your sword, it should be round 3. I like to always go for the jump attack first, because that does double damage. And then just rush him with the flurry. But alright. With that, you got the skull hammer. Alright, cool. This thing. Very fun. And it looks cool. But it's gonna be hella or what those things are called. Something blends. Same way that we got to the room before. Going to take our sword out, we're gonna back up. Grab that. Come over here. And we're gonna change the wind, so it's blowing straight that way. And then is our leaf, and fly all the way across. So, not sure how well I can do this, but, oh wait, I have Grandma's soup, but I might be able to do it actually. Okay. I better do this. Goodness. Oh, darn. Oh, why didn't I think of this first? That chest is just a joy pendant, so unless you're trying to get more of those, don't waste your time with it. That's why you get the compass on this go around, because it's trying to like take you through more of the fortress and give you opportunity to like collect all the chests for people who like to do that, but which is also why like when we tried to shortcut our way through it, it took us back the long way around. So did I go back the wrong way? Taking Fortress isn't really as bad as people think. It's just because when you first go through here, you don't have a sword, so it's a pain in the neck. Yeah, that's what we need him. Alright, now we've made our way back to the top of Forsaken Fortress. We finally opened the last door, so let's go in. Anyway, thank you guys so much for watching as that Vulcublin tried to ruin the ending. But anyway, thank you guys so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please leave a like, and I will see you in the next one. Bye.